The Spanish Grand Prix has been a permanent fixture on the Formula One calendar for over 30 years now, and for good reason. Do you remember Michael Schumacher's absolute dominance here in that rain-soaked Grand Prix in 1996? That day he took his first ever victory for Ferrari, and we've had many more iconic moments since. The Circuit de Barcelona-Catalunya, a track that will certainly force the drivers to push themselves. It consists of a very impressive main straight going into turn one. It's a straight that also offers a DRS zone, so it's likely to be a hot spot for overtakes. Anthony Davidson is here once again for today's Grand Prix. Let's talk about the rookie. They're starting towards the back of the field today. Carver is fast, so they'll be disappointed, won't they?
It's not a nice feeling, I promise you. They've got a quick car underneath them, but they've got onto the grid today and they need a pair of binoculars to see the start lights. They'll be desperate for a good start to make up for some of that deficit.
With the race minutes away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Sebastian Vettel has a clear track ahead of him today. He starts in pole position, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Leclerc, Sainz, Valtteri Bottas, and Ricciardo, Verstappen, Norris, Gasly, and Esteban Ocon, Perez, Grosjean, the rookie, and De Vries, Kvyat, Magnussen, George Russell, and Lance Stroll, Giovinazzi, Latifi, Albon, and Juan Manuel Correa. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head to trackside for today's race.
Fantastic podium result at the last race. Let's see if we can do it again today. Bite is good, gearbox is responding normally. Make sure to warm up the tyres and brakes. Warm the tyres and brakes throughout the lap. Radar is clear. Weather is looking good for now. Dry seem like the fastest tyre at the moment. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid has formed. Be ready with the clutch. position on lap one. That's not great, but it's not terrible. Stay focused. Will be enabled this lap. You can use it when within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. The car behind is dropping back by about 3/10 a lap. We'll be right back. reducing the gap on the car behind by 5/10 per lap. Is 6.5 seconds. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Got that confirmed? Is starting to create a gap. They're starting to pull away from us. approaching the pit window, you'll be on the hards. You're increasing the gap on the car behind by 5/10 per lap. Expect the grip levels to start falling away soon. To teammate ahead is 3.0 seconds. Some information on Giovinazzi. They have an issue with their car. They're going to be slow. Now, we're boxing this lap. Gap of about 3 seconds between you and the next car. man is in the pits. Release. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. Engine is looking a little worn. Power output will be less than optimal. Okay, the gap behind is 1.7 seconds. Moving to mix 2, fuel to mix 2. To the car in front is 2.4 seconds. Hamilton's out in front. We'll be right back. The car behind is dropping back by about 3/10 a lap. Close the gap to the car ahead. It's currently 2 seconds. Caution. Okay, clear. Roll down ahead, you're sat in P2. The gap to the car ahead is 2.0 seconds. They're on old hards. Perez is behind you. Our gap behind is 4.7 seconds. They're on old hards. Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. 6 laps to go. We have 5 laps of fuel remaining. There's 3 laps of fuel remaining. Second place, you're in second place. Roman is ahead of you. Gap to car in front is 2.4 seconds. They're on old hards. Hamilton is behind you. The gap to the car behind is 3.2 seconds. They're on old mediums. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. 2 laps left. Next time by will be your final lap. There's only 1 lap of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. Thank you for all your hard work out there. That was a strong drive and a good finish. Well done.
A real team effort which has paid off in spades. A great victory here at the Spanish Grand Prix. And talk to me. What do you think it was that sealed the win for them?
Well, Crofty, this was won through an abundance of speed and an abundance of skillful overtakes. Inside, outside, cutting underneath, we saw it all today. And it's really nice to see a Grand Prix won in that manner. A race, surely, that will satisfy the purists today, I think.
Well, I'm thoroughly exhausted after the excitement of that race, but I'm sure it's nothing compared to our drivers here. They've worked hard to make it up there, and it's great to see them make their way out onto the podium. So let's review the updated driver standings. The rookie increases their championship lead. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Well, it's absolutely got to be Alexander Albon, no hesitation. He put in a performance today that's only going to build further upon his already growing reputation.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. The owner driver's team moved to the top of the table. Meanwhile, Ferrari have improved their position. A strong weekend from them as they fight their way towards the top. Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.